गुड आफ्टरनून ऑल, वेलकम बैक टू गॉस लॉ क्लास. द लास्ट क्लास वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट हाउ टू कैलकुलेट इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड ड्यू टू हॉलो स्फीयर, थिन शेल्स, कंडक्टिंग, नॉन कंडक्टिंग, सॉलिड कंडक्टिंग, ओनली चार्ज ओनली डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड ऑन द सर्फेसेस फॉर दिस बॉडीज and solid non-conducting spheres or dielectrics or charge is distributed completely inside uniform charge distribution. Right, with that we'll once again we'll have a recap of that one formulas, then we'll discuss IIT advanced question which is asked in 2014 and 2000 integer type also. So two questions, previous IIT advanced level questions, how they'll be asking. So based on that, so whatever the concept that we learn, will they useful, how much they will be useful to do IIT advanced level problems, let us see today. Then we'll switch to electric potential today. Okay, right. First, Patrick, I want to calculate electric field. Electric field due to why is it visible clearly? Electric field due to yes or no? Only yes. Okay. Hollow sphere. First one is hollow sphere. Or thin shells, or thin shells will be saying, or conducting, and non-conducting, right? Conducting, non-conducting. Or we'll be saying that solid conducting. So this is all if you take charges only at the surfaces. Charges only on the surface. So charge distribution on a surface. On a surface, right? On surface. We'll take it as two parts here. Much on surface. So inside, if I take insides, first one is inside means R will be less than capital R. Inside means R is less than capital R. Fine. Can you tell me anybody what is the electric field inside E is equal to? Can anybody tell inside? The charge is distributed on the surface. What is the electric field inside? Anybody? There? Zero. Very good. It's nothing but zero. Right. Next, outside. If I take outside, R is greater than capital R. R is greater than capital R. If we take the formula for it, so what is the formula? E is equals to, we'll get E equal to, outside is always 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, K is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, Q by R square, right? This is nothing but Q by R square. K is nothing but 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught outside. So what formula exactly we got? Can anybody tell? What exactly formula? Then we can transform this into KQ by R square. What is the formula we got? Sigma R square, am I right? Anybody? Epsilon naught divided by small r square. So this is the formula we can convert into KQ by R square. Hope you got it as now. How of you? Yes? No, bully? Yes? All of you? Got it? Is it clear? Body is clear? Yes? respond, all of you? Yes? Okay. So E is equal to sigma R square by sigma capital R square by epsilon naught into R square. This is one thing. Right? Next, if I take a solid, see here outside R is greater than capital R at small r. Small r is less than capital R here. Now, if I take a solid non-conducting, So here a solid conducting, and solid non-conducting, how they are differs from each other. Solid non-conducting sphere, charge is distributed completely inside. Charge will be distributed completely inside, then we'll be calling solid non-conducting sphere. Or we can say that a dielectric. In this one, charge is uniformly distributed. So charge uniform distribution, uniformly charge is distributed, right? That means inside a hole, the charge will be there. That means at this point, E will not become zero. Inside we have some value. That is R inside, if I take inside, R is less than a capital R. R is less than capital R inside. If I take inside, what is the formula that I can get? So already we converted that E is equals to, right, K is nothing but 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught K capital Q by R cube into small r. How we are getting this formula? What is the result that we got? Can anybody tell? What is the result? Then we converted into this one. Anybody results? E is equals to, which is nothing but E equals to, right? Everybody? Rho into R by 3 epsilon naught. Rho into small r by 3 epsilon naught. So if you convert this, the same thing will be getting K cube by R cube into R. Yesterday class we discussed this one. Right? Okay. Next, outside, if I take outside R is greater than R. Outside, same formula will get, there is no change in this one, which is nothing but E is equals to KQ by R square, same thing, which we got it as. How we are getting? Okay. Oh my God. Unmute. So, E is equal to K cube by R square. How we are getting rho R cube? This can also be written as rho R cube divided by. So what we got results? Okay, rho R cube divided by 3 epsilon naught into R square. This is nothing but electric field intensity there. Is it clear? Fine. Yes. Clear? All of you? Okay. Now, let me clearly explain here once again. Electric field due to halo. This is halo electric field. Just you can take a screenshot here. Then we'll proceed. Done. Yes. Yes. No. Kindly give a response. Screenshot over. Yes? No. Okay. Now, you can see here, electric field due to halo sphere or thin shell or conducting, non-conducting, solid conducting on charge on the surface. Charge will be on the surface. If I take inside, this nothing but R is less than R, then it is nothing but E is equal to 0. Outside, if I take outside R is greater than R, then E is equal to KQ by R square. Or this will be E is equal to sigma R square by epsilon naught into R square. Now coming to solid and non-conducting, solid and non-conducting sphere or dielectric uniform charge distribution. So if I take inside KQ by R square, or this is nothing but this. So from this we'll be getting E is equals to rho R by 3 epsilon naught. Then outside, if I take here it is outside R greater, here it is nothing but inside, we're getting KQ by R square, and this nothing but from which we are getting the equation. Is it clear till this point? Anybody have any doubts? So whatever we discussed, just we are trying to show you. Right, take a screenshot. This IIT JEE 2014 question, advanced level question, asked on this concept. That is solid non-conducting sphere or dielectric uniform charge distribution. In this, one should know inside formula KQ by R cube into R. And if you take it on the surface, simply you can substitute R anywhere, you'll get the answer on the surface. Outside, if I take it as KQ by R square. So 1, 2, 3. So while discussing the problem, I'll ask the formula here, whatever there, you should able to tell. Okay. If I erase this one, you should able to tell orally that what is the formula, or you can type it as E is equal to KQ by R cube into R. That is inside, outside will not change KQ by R square. So in terms of densities, if you take it as rho into R by 3 epsilon naught, here rho into R cube by 3 epsilon naught into R square. Is it clear, all of you? Sure. I'll erase the problem. Erase the things here on the boards. Okay, this is a question taken from this book. Okay, page number, if you want, your page number is 424. Page number is 424. Page number, right? Page number is 424. Question number is 6. Right? So if you have this book, you can see from it. Right? Okay. Let me start the problem. So what we discussed here, it will be useful in this point. Here, 1, 2, 3 spheres are there. We're able to see spheres, that is a dielectric solid spheres is saying. Dielectric solid spheres. So when you carefully observe here, charge distribution, if I take charge distribution is a Q, 2Q and 4Q. Charge distributions. And he is asking us to calculate electric field intensity E1, E2, E3 at different points. Can you tell me this is the point at which outside? I can say this is outside. Outside. It's nothing but on the surface. Outside, on the surface. Okay. And next, if you see this one, inside the surface. So outside, on the surface, inside the surface, dielectric solid sphere, charge is uniformly distributed. See, whatever we derived, this one will be used. Here, if I take outside, what is the formula for outside? E is equal to KQ by R square. Outside is what? KQ by R square. Simply, I'll substitute that K for this one, E1 equal to K, Q divided by R square. Q is Q only. R square. R square means this distance. What is the distance outside? So here we want not radius of this one. At what distance we want to calculate? From center to P point is how much? R. That means simply I can write it as R square. Right? One is completed. Next, second one, we'll go for second one. If I go to second one, E2 equal to E2 equal to K. If I take on the surface, yes, yes or no? On the surface, yes, all of you, yes or no? Yes, on the surface, this is nothing but on the surface. Right, 1, 2, 3, like this, I'll be dividing. Right, fine. So Q, 4, Q, and so on. So E2 is equal to K on the surface. On the surface means KQ by R square. KQ by R square. So KQ. Q is how much now? 2Q here. K is how much? 2Q. So this is nothing but the 2Q divided by R square. R square means R only. Because at what distance we want to calculate, that is nothing but R square. So it is nothing but R square over. Now coming to inside, see, you can see inside. E is equal to K cube by R cube into small r. K cube by R cube. K cube by R cube into small r. Let us substitute that one. Now E3 equal to K into Q. Q is how much here? 4Q. S? Yes or no? 4Q. It is nothing but 4Q. This is 4Q divided by how much distance? At what distance is asking? This nothing but a radius. Here it is nothing but a distance. Radius of that is nothing but 2r whole cube. This is a 2r whole cube radius. And distance, if I take, this is the distance. At what distance it will be from the center? R. This nothing but r. Right? If I substitute this one, E3 equals to K into 4q. 4q, this is 8. So much you'll get q by 2r square. Am I right? E3 is equal to k cube by 12. This is nothing but 2r cube. 1r, 1r get cancelled. Here it will be 8, 4 and 8. That is nothing but 2. K cube by 2r square. Hope you got it as now. Now, if I take. So E2, E1. Now E1, if I take, E1 is equal to KQ divided by R square. Next, E2 equals to K into 2Q divided by R square. Now comparison of this one, which is greater? Which one is greater? Can you tell me the order of it? Anybody? Koi bol sakte, which is greater? Which is greater? Which is greater, I'm asking. Which is greater? E2 is greater first. So E2 is greater than. Now tell me, E2 is greater than. Next order, E1 or E3. Next is what? E1. Next, it will be E3. So this will be the answer which is given in IIT Advance. Hope you got it as all of you. Yes, Aya. Yes or no, boliye. Yes. Okay. So that means option is what? Option is C will be the option which is given in JEE Advance 2014. Right? We understood all of you? Yes, no, boliye. Yes. You feel any difficulty in this one? If you feel any difficulty in this one? On the surface, outside the surface, inside the surface. Whatever we derived yesterday, based on that concept, we are proceeding it. Fine. Right. If you take this question is given in this book, you can from this book you can see. The question is 18th question. Question number is 18th. Integer type question. Page number 426. 426 page number. What exactly is asking here? Let us see. First, if I take here. Integer type. This is a integer type JEE Advanced 2012. Question, any question, any material, that means any previous IIT JEE question, you can see this one. So what it's saying is like if there is a cylinder, it's nothing but infinite long solid cylinder and a uniform charge distribution. Uniform charge distribution, infinite long solid cylinder, radius is r and rho is the density. At a particular point P, we'd like to calculate what is the electric field intensity. This is nothing but a cavity. This is the cavity, saying that the cavity this is, right? It's nothing but cavity. Fine. Now to calculate first, how we can use logic here. First, I want to calculate at this particular point electric field intensity. See, electric field at this particular point is due to two things are there. One is due to cylinder. One is due to this cavity. Two things it will be there. But this is remote. This is cavity means it is remote from it. So how we can calculate electric field intensity at point P? So I can write now electric field intensity at point P can be written as, if I want the electric field intensity due to this whole cylinder minus this part. Whole cylinder minus this part. You have to subtract it. So electric field intensity due to the cylinder minus electric field intensity due to the shell of sphere. The hollow sphere. It looks like a hollow sphere. Charge is distributed on the outer surface. Fine. So if I do this one, I can obtain. Fine. So we have to do two things and we have to subtract it. Now first, electric field intensity to cylinder at this particular point. Now what I'll do, I'll construct a Gaussian surface and I'll substitute. Gaussian surface around this one. Let me construct from this point. I'll try to construct a Gaussian surface, cylindrical Gaussian surface of length L. You can take it as length is L. Cylindrical Gaussian surface is constructed here. Right. First, what I am trying to calculate electric field intensity due to the cylinder. For that sake, what I constructed a cylindrical Gaussian surface. A cylindrical Gaussian surface of length L. Let us take length is L. Fine. Length is L. Now to calculate. So flux due to cylinder, if I want to write flux formula E dot A. So this is nothing but E into dot dA. Cos theta. Let us take it as this is nothing but closed integral E phi. But at this particular point, if I take electric field intensity, this is nothing but positively charged distributed body. We can say all positive charges in this one, right? So all positive charges. Fine. Now, so flux due to this one, integral of E dA cos theta. If I take at this particular point, so I take electric field intensity and area, electric field intensity, this is nothing but electric field intensity, fine, away from the positive charge, and dA at this particular point, dA, if I take dA and electric field, both are in the same direction. Both are in what? Same direction. Theta can be written as 0. So we'll be getting phi due to cylinder can be written as E into dA integral of dA into cos 0 is nothing but 1. Here theta can be written as 0 degree. Cos 0 is how much? 1. Is it clear this one? Phi c is equals to E into integral of dA. Integral of dA is nothing but A. What is the area of this Gaussian surface? So if I take it as phi c is equals to E into area. Area is nothing but 2 pi r. Radius of this Gaussian surface is 2 r, right? Constructed at a distance of 2 r, around it 2 r, right? That's nothing but 2 r into l. So phi c is equal to E into 2 pi into r. R is nothing but 2 r into l. Just constructed. 2r into l. Now what we can write, phi c is nothing but a q inside divided by epsilon naught equals to E into, this is a 4 pi r into l, q inside. What I require, q inside, I require how to calculate q inside. So this is nothing but a solid, okay, infinite charge. It is a long solid cylinder. Solid cylinder means density is equals to, that is a charge density. Charge density can be written as Q divided by V. Q divided by V inside if I want. Now inside can be calculated Qi is equals to rho into V, or I can write it as rho into. Can you tell me what is the volume of the sphere? So this radius is nothing but R. R is the radius. Pi R square L is nothing but pi R square. Take this and substitute here instead of Q, then what I'll get? So I'll take this QI here. What I got? QI rho into pi R square into L divided by pi R, rho into pi R square into L divided by epsilon naught is equals to E into 4 pi R L. E into 4 pi R L. So L get cancelled. Here 1R get cancelled. Pi pi will get cancelled. So what I can write now, E is equals to, if I take E, nothing but E. So what is remaining thing here? Rho into R divided by 4 epsilon naught. This is due to cylinder. Is it clear, this one? What is rho into R by 4 epsilon naught? Clear? So what we did, we want electric field intensity at a point P. If I want at a point P, then EC minus ES. EC minus ES. EC is nothing but electric field intensity due to the cylinder, and minus electric field intensity to that sphere. First, I am trying to calculate the flux due to the cylinder. That is nothing but E integral of E into dA cos theta. Here, theta is equals to 0. Then I substituted this one. We are getting, we know this formula. Rho is equal to QI by V. Simply, I substituted. Finally, I am getting EC is equals to rho R by 4 epsilon naught. Till here, if you have any doubt, let me know to take a screenshot. And done. All of you. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes. Done. We proceed, all of you. Done. A simple thing, two things we have to calculate and we have to subtract it. So what we have to do, you just what I did right now. Here a cylinder is there at the particular point. From what distance we have to calculate electric field intensity? We have to calculate at a distance of 2R. Okay. At a distance of 2R, we want to calculate so that first cylinder. For this particular cylinder, I am calculating. Fine. I am calculating intensity. Then I'll take the cavity, electric field intensity. Then we'll subtract. That's all. Okay. Sure. Now next, we'll take, this is like this only. Let's make it like this. Keep that result there itself. I'll write the result here. What is the result we got? EC is equal to EC. EC equal to EC equal to rho R divided by 4 epsilon naught. This is electric field intensity due to the cylinder. Due to cylinder LRH. And in the question, he has given rho R K into epsilon. Okay. It's a given one. In the question, he is asking us to calculate what is the value of R. Right? Okay. Fine. Now I want to calculate for solid sphere. So it's nothing but a halo, halo shell, or it is nothing but a halo shell. We are going to calculate here. So solid shell, or otherwise a shell, thin shell, we can say it as. So outside this point, this is there. Let us imagine there is a halo shell is there. Outside we want to calculate. If I want to calculate outside, what is the formula for outside? E equal to k q by r square. K q divided by r square. It's nothing but inside. We want it inside directly. There is no need of flux and all those things. Right. Directly I can take. I'm using the equation as it is outside. Outside, it will not change. E is equal to kq by r square. If I take, what is the q? Here, rho is equal to q inside divided by volume. Inside, if I want to calculate. So, its radius is given how much? R by 2 is given. If I want to calculate volume, q inside can be calculated as q inside is equal to rho into volume. Volume can be written as 4 by 3 pi r cube. But what is r inside? R is nothing but r by 2. That means r by 8. Am I right? R is the radius. R is what? Radius r by 8. R cube by 8. Simply we'll substitute this one here. Now k into q. Qi. Qi is nothing but rho into 4 by 3 pi r cube divided by 8. Divided by what? R square. E is equals to. So if you calculate this one, E equal to what you'll get? K into rho into 4. Can I will tell? 4 divided by how much here we'll be getting? Divided by R square. R square is nothing but this is at a distance of how much distance it is? 2R whole square. At a distance of 2r whole square. Here it will be 4. Here it is 16, 24. 24 into 4. 96. So we'll be getting rho k into rho into r divided by 96 epsilon naught. Just you can check it out whether it is correct or not. So k into rho. So k into rho r. K will be get cancelled here. Anyhow, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught will be there. So here 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. If I substitute, right? So epsilon naught will be getting. K is nothing but 1 by 4 pi. Otherwise, you can substitute here 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught and you can check it out. Here 4 pi will get cancelled. Epsilon naught will come to denominator. Right? So rho into r by 96 epsilon naught. This is due to E. E is due to sphere. Halo shell. Halo sphere. Rho r by 96 epsilon naught. This is due to sphere and this is due to cylinder. So rho r by 4 epsilon naught due to cylinder. Rho r by 96 epsilon. Is it clear? Just what I use the formula. Outside. Outside is what? KQ by r square. KQ by r square. Outside. Right. Outside is kq by r square. K is nothing but 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Outside formula will be same for conducting, non-conducting, uniform distribution, non-uniform distribution. Outside will not change. As on the surface, inside the surface. Inside the surface always varies for conducting or non-conducting or halo. Right? Uniform charge distribution and non-uniform charge distribution. Hope you are getting this one. Right? Okay. Now, rho r by 96 epsilon naught. Here it is rho into r by 4 epsilon naught. Simply we can substitute that one. Try to substitute and find it out the value of k. Meanwhile, so take the screenshots. Previously you took. Take a screenshots. Done. Yes. Yes, no. Fast you respond. Yes, one you take, that's because I'm sending the PDF. Spurti, you took? here. Where is this one? Right. If I take ES is equal to, I'll substitute here. Now ES due to sphere, I got rho into capital R divided by 96 epsilon naught. Take these two and substitute in this one. Erase this one. Right. Now E at this particular point, E at the point P equal to, if we want at this particular point, E is equal to EC. EC is nothing but the rho into R by 4 epsilon naught minus rho into R divided by 96 epsilon naught. So take common. So E at the point P equals to rho R by epsilon naught, if I take it as common, 1 by 4 minus 1 by 96. Can you tell me how much you are getting it as? 23 by 96 emirates. So EP equals to 23 rho into R by 96 epsilon naught. 23 rho R by 96 epsilon naught. Right? Now this is the expression we got, but we have to compare with this one. 23 rho into R we got. Here are 16k epsilon naught. 16k epsilon naught is there. Are you able to see? 23 rho into R divided by 16k epsilon naught. What we got here? EP is equals to 23 rho into R divided by 96 epsilon naught. Is it clear? So just if it is 16 is multiplied with 6, we'll get the answer. Yeah. K is equal to, comparing both the things, so 16K equals to 96 or 6 is equal to, K is equal to 6. This is the answer for that one. So answer is K is equal to 6. Is it fine? All of you? Note it down. Then we proceed. Take a screenshot to list. Electric potential. So for this weekend syllabus, we have even electric potential is there. Right? What is electric potential? Actually, there is no term called electric potential, strictly speaking. There is a potential difference. Okay? Potential difference. So from potential difference only, we are getting electric potential. So first, let me explain what is electric potential difference. Then we'll go to what is electric potential, right? So to discuss electric potential, one should know what is electric potential. Electric potential. To discuss this electric potential, right? Electric potential. We should know electric potential difference. Electric potential difference. Electric potential difference. What is electric potential difference? Right? Ready? What is electric potential difference? Now let me take 2 points, A and B. I'm taking 2 points. Right? I'm taking 2 points. If I want to bring a charge from B to A, if I want to bring a charge from B to A, that is, let me take a test charge, Q naught. Hopefully, you know what is test charge. Can anybody tell? What is test charge? Already we discussed. What are the properties of the test charge? What is the test charge? What is the properties? Test charge is small charge. Small charge. And next it is positive charge. It is a positive. Next, the effect of it. So no electric force. No effect of electric force. effect of electric force. That means it does not produce any electric force. Okay. Now I have a Q naught, the charge is there. If I want to bring this Q naught from B to A, if I want to take this Q naught from B to A, if I want to bring, right? I have to do some work, right? We will be calling that work is external work, because external force, we have to apply external force. That means I am bringing this one from where to where? From B to A. So I can say this is nothing but external work done. I am doing some external work done. External work done. I am doing from where to where? To bring a charge from B to A. Bring a charge from B to A. External work is done. Right? Then how to give the definition of electric potential? How to give the definition of electric potential? See, potential at A, let me take it as VA. Potential at B is nothing but VB. So I'm bringing a charge from B to A. This is the final. This will be initial. If I want potential difference VA minus VB is equals to VA minus VB. VA minus VB means I am bringing a charge from B to A. So it means A will be final, and B will be initial. That means this can be written as final, this can be written as initial. What I am doing? I am doing external work. I am bringing a charge from B to A. कहाँ लेके आ रहे हैं? B to A लेके आ रहे हैं, right? So that means external work. अब देखो external work कहाँ लेके आ रहे हैं? B to A लेके आ रहे हैं. So B to A external work divided by the charge. This is nothing but what we call is as electric potential difference. This is defined. So if I ask what is electric potential difference means, what do you say? Work done to bring a charge from where to where? From B to A. Work done by the external agent to bring a test unit, a positive test charge from B to A is called electric potential difference. If I want the electric potential difference between two points A and B means work done to bring B to A. A to B if I want, B to A work is done divided by charge to it. Fine? Okay? The charge, what are the conditions here? This is nothing but electric potential difference, but it is not electric potential. What is this electric potential difference? What I want? Electric potential difference it is. This is electric potential. In this one, what are the conditions? Condition number one. See, when I am bringing B to A, the charge should be moved very slowly. Charge should be moved very, very slowly. Right. Charge should be moved slowly. You have to bring very slowly. You have to bring to point A. We have to bring till point A. In that one, no change in the speed. So there should not be change. No change in speed. There should not be any change in the speed. Or kinetic energy. There should not be any change in the kinetic energy of charge Q naught. So these are the points to be noted. Charge should be moved very, very slowly, and no change in the speed. There should not be any change in the speed. Then kinetic energy is nothing but, because if there is a change, if there is no change in the speed, then you should maintain that there is no change in the speed. If there is a change in the speed, then this cannot be valid, right? Now, clearly. Now, I want to bring, if I want to give the definition of electric potential. Hope you got this one, electric potential difference, all of you. What is electric potential difference? Electric potential difference. And one more thing is, work done is equal to change in kinetic energy. See, from work energy theorem, work done is equal to change in kinetic, final kinetic energy minus initial kinetic energy. There should not be change in kinetic energy. It should not be changed. It should remain constant. Always work done through a closed path is what? Zero. For conservative forces, electrostatic force is a conservative force. Work done to a closed path is zero. And work done is independent of the path followed by its. Almost all we discussed all the things in our first year, right? Conservative force is electrostatic force. So there also we discussed when it has to be more slowly. Okay. Till here completed, just take a screenshot. Then we'll move. What is the potential? Electric potential. We start. What is electric potential? Done. Electric potential. Yes. Till here, anybody have any doubts? Let me know. Be clear. Right? No doubts, Supali Reddy. Okay. Please try to ask the doubts if you have anything or about visibility of the board and all those things. Already we are sending the notes to you, right? PDF. So yes, it's clear, Urvi, good. And one more thing is, you even you have to check your data. If the data problem from your side, little difficulty will be there. Okay. And if you are running on this Wi-Fi, there is no problem, there is no issues. So those who are running this app, Zoom app on data, little they may face little difficulty. So sometimes it will be clear, sometimes it is not clear. It happens with most of the students. Okay, the technical aspects we have to take care of it because there is no other option for us. Okay, to communicate the classes. Fine. Is it okay, all of you? Done? Sure. So what I want to say now, what I want to say, electric potential due to a point. What is electric? Potential difference is always between two points. Electric potential is due to one point. Due to one point. If I want only potential at A, only potential at B, how to calculate it? Right? Now, I'll do this one. Now, if I want potential at A, what should I do? This Q naught should bring from infinity. Infinity se leke aana padega. So infinity, if I take, this is nothing but infinity. Agar Q naught is at infinity, samjo, why we are taking Q naught at infinity, let me know. So infinity se point A tak leke aa. Then what should I write? Va minus v infinity, am I right? This will be at now infinity. A b point kya ho jayega? Infinity ban jayega. Right? So I am trying to bring the charge from infinity to the given point. Idhar tak leke aa raha hu main, given point tak leke aa raha hu. That is va minus v infinity is equals to work done by external agent. Kahan se kahan leke aa rahe hum log? We are bringing from infinity to point A. So the reverse likhna padega. Now infinity to point A divided by Q naught. Is it clear this one? Va minus V infinity is equal to work external from where to where? Infinity is a point A tak leke aa raha hu, divided by Q naught. Okay. Va minus V infinity. Va minus V infinity. So V infinity, potential at infinity is always considered to be zero. Potential at infinity is zero. Imagine this. Okay. So all books. Okay. So according to potential at infinity, if you go, So at that particular point, it is zero. That is the reference point. From there onwards, we have started calculating. Now, VA is equals to, this nothing but VA equal to external agent, work done external agent to bring from infinity to point A divided by Q naught. This is nothing but, we call it as electric potential due to the point charge. So electric potential at a point A. Electric potential at point A. If I take units for its units, joule per coulomb, and it is nothing but a scalar quantity. It is scalar quantity. Just take it down that one. Take a screenshot. So we are bringing the charge again as the electric field. Okay, all of you. Okay, now see here, very important thing in this one. Very important thing. If I want potential at any point, remember, now in coming classes, what we are going to discuss. If I want potential at any points, if you want to calculate potential at any points, what you have to do is take a charge, test charge, bring that test charge from infinity to the given points. For example, you want potential in your house at your points. What you have to do? You have to bring the charge from infinity to your given points. Then potential at that point can be obtained. How to calculate how much work is done to bring the charge from infinity to the given points? That is nothing but work done divided by charge. How much charge? Test charge. Is it clear till this point? Hopefully, right? Okay. So, joule per coulomb, and here work is done again as the electric force. Work is done again as the electric force. And work done is nothing but here electrostatic force is nothing but conservative force. That means it is not depending on the path. For example, if I take this portion only, I'll take. So I'm taking here one. Or if I take like this two. Or if I take like this three. Right? W1, W2, W3. Nothing to worry about it. So work done will be equal. W1 is equal to W2 is equal to W3. All work done are equal. There is no change in this one. Because electrostatic force is a conservative force. Conservative means round the trip work done will be zero. Okay. If I take this is A. This point is B. Right. A, B. Again A. A to B. Here we are taking A to B. B to A. That means, for example, A, B is there. You are going from A to B and B to A, work done, A to B to B to A, closed loop is zero. Closed loop is what? Zero. Right? So two things is the conservative things. Work done, W is work done is path independent. It does not depends on path, what we are taking the charge. Okay. And the second thing is electrostatics is a conservative force. Electrostatic force is a conservative force. And third thing is, if you take it as work done, all work done are equal. And fourth one is closed round trip, it will be zero. So if you want simply what is the potential at a particular point, so you got two things here, potential difference, potential. What is the meaning of potential difference? You have, if I have two points, I have to bring a charge from B se A tak leke aao. B se A tak leke aao, test charge. Tab kya ho jayega? Potential difference between VA minus VB. VA minus VB. VA minus VB. Agar VB le lete to. So work done by the external agent from bringing the charge from B to A. A to B potential difference आये, work is done from B to A, reverse divided by charge. That's what potential difference. If I want only potential समझो, खाली potential at that particular points. So दो points तो है, okay? Is it clear? Hello? Hello? Fine. So at the two points are there. We have two points. Fine. So I think time is up for today's class. Right? Hope only two things we are discussing here. Two charges, if you take it as. Two points, how to calculate the potential difference. For one point, how to calculate the potential. Just to take a screenshot, if you have any doubts, let me know. Okay. No doubts. Good.